In my last video, we looked at why sex exists, why it's better to reproduce sexually instead of cloning yourself. Now let's look at how sex leads to differences between the sexes. Why are males and females different? Sex happens by taking two cells, one from each parent, and fusing them together. These cells are designed for sex. They're called gametes. These gametes could fuse together in several different ways. One possibility is they could be equal partners. They could split everything in half, 50-50. That seems fair, but life isn't fair. Instead of thinking about fairness, think about different competing strategies. One strategy is to make a few large gametes. Another strategy is to make many small gametes and have them find the large gametes. This is a good strategy because you can find many partners and reproduce with them. As one gamete gets smaller, the other is inclined to grow bigger. If it's not big enough, the offspring may not survive. Going halfway is not good enough. You risk losing everything. Bigger is better. So we have two strategies, and both are necessary. The first strategy is to produce many small, fast-moving gametes. This strategy by itself cannot work. If they're all small, then none of them can find a good match. They need a big gamete to survive. On the other hand, if all the gametes are big, that doesn't work either. Big gametes are expensive. They're few and far between. They may never find each other. They need the small gametes as much as the small gametes need them. We have two strategies giving us two sexes, males and females. Males produce many small, fast-moving gametes, like sperm for animals and pollen for plants. On the other hand, females produce just a few big gametes, like eggs for animals and ovules for plants. The average adult male produces about 200 million sperm cells per day. If he could somehow get each of these sperms into an egg, he could, theoretically speaking, repopulate the globe in a month. In the same month, an adult female releases a single egg. Eggs are very expensive. For humans, sex is based on chromosomes. Males have XY chromosomes, females have XX. But this is not the only way to do it. For birds, males have ZZ chromosomes, females have ZW. And it's not really about chromosome. What it means to be biologically male is that you produce many small gametes. In turtles, sex depends on the temperature of the egg you hatched in, not chromosomes. Some animals can switch from making eggs to making sperm. Some frogs can switch between being male and being female. This is a plot point in the movie Jurassic Park. And some animals produce both sperm and eggs. They're both male and female. They're called hermaphrodites. Slugs and plants are hermaphrodites. When males and females have sex, the female does most of the work of reproduction. She lays the eggs or delivers the children. She does most of the work. Her partner can help, but only indirectly. This gives males and females different attitudes about sex. A female has a limited number of eggs that can be fertilized. She has to make a choice. She could let Adam fertilize the eggs, or she could let Bob do it. But she has to choose between them. She has to pick the best partner. But males are different. They don't need to be so picky. Adam could fertilize Alice's eggs, Betty's eggs, Claire's eggs, and 100 of their closest friends. He would be happy to donate sperm to all of them. Males are usually less picky about who they have sex with. Now, this isn't the whole story. In many species, couples form tight bonds. They fully commit themselves to one partner. For these species, males are just as picky as females. Different species have different mating behaviors. Some species stick to one partner. Some have many partners. If you're a swan, you stick to one partner for life. If you're an elephant seal, you could keep a harem of 100 females. Fruit flies have many partners. A female fly is very picky about who she mates with. A male fly is not picky at all. He'll mate with a piece of wax if you wiggle it the right way. Humans are sort of monogamous. Monogamy is the norm, but casual sex, cheating, and adultery are not uncommon. This explains some of the differences between men and women. Now, these differences are not absolute. I'm not saying that men and women are totally different. There's plenty of overlap between them. in general, men are less picky about who they sleep with. They're interested in signs of youth infertility. A woman's fertility peaks in her early 20s and gradually declines thereafter. Men are particularly interested in that early range. Women are more picky about who they sleep with. Men need to impress them. They need to show off their abilities, their ability to fight, or to jump, or to sing, or to dance, or to give her gifts, or to protect her, or to build beautiful nests, or grow beautiful feathers, or make educational YouTube videos.
Girls only want boyfriends who have great skills.
What do you mean?
You know, like nunchuck skills, bow hunting skills, computer hacking skills.
For more astronomical videos, please click to subscribe.